Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. This is a simple CRUD application using JSP with MySQL. Here let us show the demo. Here I am going to go to open the localhost MySQL. Right. Now I have created the database which has GC hotel, this one. Inside the database we have only one column, right, this one table which is a room. Now let's back to here. Right, now here I am going to register room number 2, room type non AC, single bed, amount I have to giving here is 2000. Click submit button, room added successfully. If you go and refresh it, here it's working perfectly well. Right, this is a simple CRUD application. We are using the JSP and MySQL, the very simple form designing. So let me see how to do the task. Right, now let me see how to do the task. Right, so that's what I'm going to do is here. First I'm going to go to open the new project. Here I have to, if default select as Java, instead of Java you have to select as Java web application. Here web, next. Here you have to give the name of this one. I'm going to type hotel GC, just name the name. Right, here if the server you must select as Apache. Okay, it is supported. Right, Glassfish also it will be work. When you put the server, the Glassfish may not be support as a SSL certification. Right, so that there is a problem on Glassfish. So Apache is a best. Right, I recommend it as Apache. Right, next. I am not work with any framework here, so I have finished it. The simple one I have get it here. So here hotel G, right? Here first what I am going, instead of HTML I am going to delete them. I am going to put it as select the web pages new. Here we have to JSP, you have to index.jsp. You no need to type the extension, it automatically taken JSP file. Okay, click finish. Right, it's working perfectly well. Now I just remove the stuff. Okay, now I am going to, I already wrote the code over here. I just copy this one, Control C, copy, Control D. I explain it. Okay, this code, you know, don't worry about that. I all the code I have pasted in my website. You will be able to download this code. Right, very simple one. So how to download? First what I did here is, here we have to HTML, inside the HTML you have to include the bootstrap style. Right, how to get the bootstrap style here is, you just go to the your bootstrap website. Right, you just go to the bootstrap website and there will be the CSS there. Right, so go to the Google, type bootstrap, click on this one, first link, get started, click on the CSS, back to the NetBeans. This is a newly created one. Right, so we have to paste it over here. If we paste it, the same code. Right, okay, I already paste it, we don't need. Okay, this is how we have to paste the CSS style. Okay, okay, this is the thing we have to do. After that we have to create a simple form design. This is simple form design, it's look like this. Simple form design where it's look like this. Okay, it's look like this, the form design. Okay, it's look like this. So a simple one. Okay, this we have to create the inside the body. We have to, first you have to create the div as a container. You have to close the div. Okay, div, you have to close the div. We didn't close it. Okay. Right, okay, container. Right, it's container. After that we have to put it another div. This is a div called this is the form group called 12p. This is meaning of this full size 12. We have set as 12. Okay, container 12. Okay, second div. Here we have to get the message. Message mean when the record is added, it will be display the message above. Record added successfully. That's why I have to put it here. That I have to provide a color as well. Also I give the code the color. I will be explain this one later on. After that I have to make the simple form design. The simple form design I have to make. Right, so here first one I have to give here the form, simple form design. First this one should be the heading. this is hotel room details, right? This should be the heading. Right, this is simple heading. Okay, heading. After that, p outer h. This one should be the this. Right. So after that, what I did here is we have to create the another simple form over here. Div class row. First, this is the first input field. Room number. Second one, we have another field. This is the called as drop down. The drop down, there will be the room type. We have two choices, AC and non-AC. So we have option two option, so that we will be able to select the option AC or non-AC. Right? So we have to select. You will be able to select this one, right? So here this is things, right? After that, we have another field, bed type. Here bed type, this is the ID, bed type. This is the room type, this is the ID, room type, this ID, bed type. We have two options too, single and double. After that, we have another field, amount, input field amount. This is another field. After that, we have one submit button at the below. The simple form design I have did it. This very professional one, you can check here. It's a very professional one. Here it is more attractive. This form should be. After all the fields we have fill all the fields. After that, click this one. Record should be added into the database. So I have created the database on MySQL. It's very simple. How to create the database, I already taught, right? So if you are not watched that one, I will provide the link in my below, the basic JSP full cred part in the video description below. You will be able to watch it. Okay, there will be the many video tutorials are there in my video description. You will be able to watch it, right? This is the database I have created. Inside database we have a row, right? This is the rooms. This is the database column. The ID should be auto incremented. Other fields are we have to fill the columns, right? Room number, room type, bed type, and amount, right? If you fill the column and click add button, its record should be added. Okay, this is the columns. This is the structure of the column. Okay, you will be able to see the ID should be auto incremented. Okay, this is the thing we have to do. Now this is a simple form, right? Okay, now after that, what I am trying to do is here we have to see the SQL part, right? So here first what I am going to do is here this is a JSP, right? This is a JSP tag. So open tag of JSP, this is a close tag, right? When you fill all the fields, room number, room type, bed type and amount, click submit button. What happens is it goes to the post method. Here this is a form, this is a for in the action method index.jsp. So this is index.php page. This goes above. We have created the two string variables. After that, we have to create one object connection object con. Here we have to create the method if request method to compare to post, right? If the record is the post is coming here as a method which has post method, right? It's a post method. In PHP we wrote this one as a isset, right? Isset post we saw in my last tutorial, yesterday tutorial. PHP we have written if isset. In JSP we have write like this, request method compare to post. This how we have to get the post requested, right? Whether if it is right, we have to zero, right? Okay, now we have to get the all the values. If the all the values of post are successfully, you are get it here. Get and we have to put into the relevant variable. So we have to get it the all the things. This all the things are here. This fields values, the name, the this one name, this name, this name. Okay, this names. Okay, and this name. Okay, this all the names are we have to get it here. If you have put it this different one, it won't work. The same name we have to get it here and assign the variables, right? Relevant variables, right? Now the same thing happen in the core Java like this. Okay, first we have to register the MySQL driver. So here library, this is a library part. Here we have to add the MySQL connect. How to add the MySQL connect, all the stuff I explained. How to download this, I already downloaded. Hold on the shift key down and select, sorry, hold on the control key down and select one by one these two and open it. It added successfully. then only it will be work. First you have to register the MySQL driver. After that you have to implement the MySQL connection. My MySQL database reside on the localhost. This is my database which name is GC Hotel. This is my database name. This is GC Hotel. Inside database we have a table called room. So here this is a table, right? This is the database name. We have a table called room. So insert into room. This is the specific column available: room number, room type, bed type, amount, right? These are the parameters we need four parameters, right? So prepare statement, we have to write the prepare statement object, create the prepare PST connection. This is a connection object, prepare statement query, right? This query we have to call it here. After that we have to run the statement, right? We have to test it whether it's working or not, right? In the console also I have to put it here. After that, this is a prepare statement, right? We have this prepare. These are all the value we are getting from the form assigned to the relevant variable. We are calling to one by one: room number, room type, bed type, and amount, right? This is all the type we are set it here. It's all the sequence of the parameters followed by the sequence of column in the table, right? These four values are set into the this question mark. These all things are set into one by one: first question mark, second question mark, third question mark, and fourth. These all the four question mark followed by the these four parameters, right? These four parameters followed by the this four question mark. It's set into the relevant fields into the table, right? After that, we have to calling the prepare statement dot execute method. It will be added into the record into the database table. After if it is all the things are done successfully, I have created the variable string color, right? The string color, change it as a red. We have created another variable message, right? Message equal room added successfully. You get it? Anything error above, it will be display the message. We have to color it should be red. If there is an error, a message error occurred. Message we have display or error. If it is success, room added successfully. Otherwise, we have message display error occurred in the inside the catch exception. Okay, this is a simple code I have written. Right? Very simple. Okay, very simple code we have to written. Right. Okay, now let's check the simple one. It's my another one. Here I have write 5, room number 5, single, AC amount 2000. We have to put it 12,000, record room added. The newly record we have created, it working perfectly well. Okay, this simple CRUD system, we have to done it successfully. If you have any doubt on this, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.